Alrighty, let's see if we get this going. Alright, I have the voice of the amplifier here. I'm going to interrupt your conversations for 1 second. It's now 1:15. We're going to push back the next presentations another 15 or 20 minutes, so don't worry. But in the interim, I want to introduce Chris. He's got an ingenious device which will help you mow your lawn with the biggest smile on your face, without emitting any greenhouse gases, and getting some exercise. We have the bicycle mower over there. I'm going to play this video a couple times on the big screen right here. But I do want you to check out what Chris has got. I know Chris, you want to come up here and use the microphone. I know it's the pillars are in the way, but just talk a little bit about what we've got going here, and maybe I'll wheel the bike around so folks can see it.
Yeah, no, it makes too much noise. But thanks, Galen. Maybe I can just use a loud voice and still be able to see everybody. I'm passing around a little info. Hopefully find a reason to get back in touch with me, either by email, bicyclemower@gmail. Traditionally on a piece of paper here, you can sign up and we can just start a conversation. So feel free to pass that along. And I wanted to have a little more time, but I've got about 15 minutes before I have to go try and sell a station wagon. So another way to get off of gas. But I was starting this with a story. In late April, I bought a flight ticket and started feeling bad about all the pollution that was going to cause. So looked at my life and saw where do I have an opportunity to reduce my greenhouse gas emissions. Come to find out, lawn care is causing 5% of our nation's greenhouse gas emissions. 1 hour of that 20-inch wide push mower that you know most people use, 1 hour is equal to 300 plus miles of drive. 1 hour of mowing is like 11 cars working for an hour. There's no emissions equipment on these small off-road engines, so it's kind of out of mind, out of sight, exempt. So we can do better. There are different ways to go off of gas when you're doing your lawn care, but all of them favor a focus on the equipment. They don't focus on the person. So the short story here is, if you're going to electrify something, why not electrify the bicycle? So this fat tire bike, it's called a fat tire bike because the tires are about 4 inches wide. This is what I use to do my half acre of lawn. It takes about 40 minutes. That's twice as long as a large landscaper that comes in. The process is a little bit different, but all the time that's normally spent on maintaining the tractor, buying the gas, oil changes, air filters, belts, all that stuff, I just put a little more time into mowing my grass and still have time left over that I'm saving versus the alternative. It gets a little bit better with the Charity Miles app that I mentioned earlier this morning. If I remember to hit record on my phone before I start biking around my yard, the Nature Conservancy gets a little bit of money. And through everyone else on Charity Mile who picked the Nature Conservancy, they're well over $50,000. So what I'd like to see in the future is an accounting of the carbon offsets. So in other words, instead of using my Craftsman 42 inch wide gas tractor, by using the bicycle, I'm creating carbon offsets that, there's a well established market for solar and wind generation of electricity. Why not also include this? The other thing we've been talking about heavily during various presentations is the safety aspect. Can you ride next to traffic? Well, here's an opportunity to ride on grass around your house, or do your neighbor's lawn, or your grandmother, or whomever. So as a homeowner, a typical, at least it seems to work well for about up to an acre. One reel towed behind a bike seems to be a pretty good fit. If you have a larger property or you're a landscaper, it's possible, again, to electrify the bicycle. So you have a pedal assist bike and three of those mowers can be towed behind it. That picture is on the sheet that I'm hoping people will take a look at. So I'm asking everyone to try to help create a movement where we move from greenhouse gas emissions due to lawn care and move to zero emissions. So keep your landscaper, if that's what you use, just insist next year that they give you an option to do zero emissions lawn mowing and also a string trimmer, the weed whacker. That can be, there's some very good battery powered ones on the market now. Just take a stand and either start to replace your own equipment, get in touch with me if you want to just talk about it, or if there's any way to, you know, contact a school or a church, whoever, wherever your life leads you, if you see a lawn is being cut, let's get fewer people using gas to do that. Currently there are a few historical examples of gas equipment being banned for lawn care. One would be if you search for smog bans. If the air quality in a city is too bad, they just say stop using gas for lawn care, wait, air a bit better. Another example would be leaf blowers. They just create so much noise. My riding tractor creates so much noise, I put ear protection on, I could barely hear my music. With this, your neighbor won't hear you, or you won't hear your neighbor when you're getting your lawns cut. So getting this type of equipment out of circulation due to noise bans, you know, that's something you can advocate for on a town-by-town basis. But really, I think in the future, as people get more awareness around the climate and the greenhouse gas emissions, this will be an easy thing to see banned. It's just people don't know what the alternatives are. They assume that it's either an electric thing with a cord that's hard to manage or a battery that's really expensive. Here, you can either have human-powered or battery-assisted mowing and make a huge dent in our nation's greenhouse gas emissions. So, did all that make sense? Question?
So we actually had a push mower that we used for a while, and it didn't work really well on our property. But I'm intrigued by this, so I'm wondering, is this something that you kind of took a push mower and retrofitted, or is this an
This is a Scott's Classic push mower. People also call them reel mowers. It just spins.
Yeah.
And the way it cuts the grass needs to be sort of in a sweet spot.
Yeah.
So maybe the first mowing would be a rotary gas-powered machine that creates a good vacuum and gets the leaves up in the spring, and also maybe the last one in the fall. But in between there, if you can use this and keep that lawn in that sweet spot, maybe you can go 10 times using this and then once with gas.
Okay.
And that'll be a great ratio. A 10-to-1 ratio would be wonderful. It comes down to what you expect your lawn to look like. So yes, you'll spend more time bicycling or pushing the reel mower around, but you'll spend less time taking care of the gas equipment, less money. It's a mental shift you have to make because it is a slightly different technique.
And it's the reduction in noise pollution too.
Yeah, there's so many benefits.
I would go out today and buy one to my neighbor, seriously, if I could.
I mean, all I want to start is a conversation.
If you could get rid of the leaf blowers, that would be
let's just start a conversation. And there's a few, you know, techniques that you have to change to make this perform at its best. So I'd be happy to share those
cool. Thank you.
One-on-one basis. Great question.
Do you make these for sale?
Yes. If you have a bicycle that has a seat post, the stuff behind it is $350. So for a homeowner, that will get you started right now. A do-it-yourselfer could build this. Maybe they might take one or two tries at getting the angles right, but that would be another way. I'm also working with some engineers to do volume production. And we're hoping to target something like $250 as the price point, including the mower. If you already have a real mower and a bicycle, that'll also reduce your costs. But the real mower, you can pick those up at a garage sale for $20 to $50, sometimes free at the dump.
Yeah, I just sold ours.
it's short money to get it back.
But yeah, no, I love this. Is a my husband would totally love this idea. So.
I hope we get in touch and continue that discussion. All right.
Thank you, Chris.
Oh, yeah. Is there, regarding the type of bike, you said electrical assist is the preferred. Is there a certain level
yes.
of...
So I'll go through a spectrum. Yeah,
yeah.
Sorry, I'm going to rush that.
Oh, no, you can't
the hardest way to do half an acre of grass is just to push this by hand. That's a good workout. Your upper body has less strength than your legs do. So if you have just any kind of bicycle, I've used my wife's bicycle, which has 1-inch wide tires. The top tube is really low, steps are designed. So, any bike will work as long as the seat height is somewhere in that vicinity. And that makes it easier than pushing the real mower. To make it even easier, you can electrify the bike. You can take the bike that you have and add electrical stuff to it. Or you can buy one off the shelf, or hopefully buy one used that fits well. I happened to buy this one with the fat tires because I took all the savings from not using my tractor and put it towards a bike that can go in the sand and the snow. And that's where these kinds of tires are needed. For grass mowing, it's probably better to have a skinnier tire.
Thank you.
Thanks.
I don't know, I gotta say the fat tire is probably
helpful.
I mean, my lawn is not worth getting my bike out for, but in terms of riding on grass, that's gotta be more comfortable.
Yeah, there's a little bit of suspension in there. You can adjust the air the way you like it, and if there's any steep hills, this will have better traction than a skinny tire. Every lawn's a little bit different, so it's kind of, if you want to talk further, you can tell me a little bit of what kind of lawn you're thinking of, whether this is even a fit, or if it's just anything that gets you off of using gas to using no gas, then we're all happy with that.
Do the wheels ever create ruts or something like in wetter weather? Or?
Ruts?
Yeah.
No, this doesn't compress the grass so much. It does leave a pattern that's different than the landscaper's equipment, so that's one adjustment that, people who care about the environment, they won't mind a different pattern. Both patterns disappear after a little bit of wind and rain and all that stuff. It's very easy to, so the real mower has four wheels on the back, but right side pair, that makes a sort of pattern in the grass. And I just put my front tire on that mark, and then the real mower overlaps the last pass by a little bit. So it's a little funny. I mean, the unseen benefits or unexpected benefits from this are in my case mostly psychological. I didn't think this was going to be so much fun, so I ended up mowing the lawn more than I probably have to get the job done. I just books on tape, music, whatever you want, and you're just getting a relationship going with the contours of your lawn, and just feeling like a kid again. So that's where this has an advantage over any the more traditional electrification technique. It's just fun, and put your time you save into a nice bicycle. You can enjoy that elsewhere. If you go the electrical pedal assist route, maybe that becomes a replacement for some of your car use, and you improve the lower your greenhouse gas.
Super neat.
Thank you.
Thanks, guys, for showing off. Yeah.
Just to reiterate, if anybody wants to see more info and get in touch with updates, it's facebook.com/bicyclemower or bicyclemower@gmail.com if you want to get in touch. Thanks.
Excellent. Good work. Thanks. It's a little outside the box thinking. Cool, so we're going to take just a few minutes. I do want to get us going in the next two presentations so that we can get out of here on time. How was lunch?
It was
awesome, right? Yeah, there's still more over there. I'll take it to the...
If we need any extras, but feel free to clean the bellies while we're here.
And we got cookies.
We need desserts.
Great.
think I saw that.
It's with mine, so I'm just going to hear them.
Okay.
So, because I thought Tom had my voting.
He did, but then he had to take some people.
Oh, okay.
And that's the bike mower.